Let's consider one problem related to operators in C. What is the output of the following C program fragment? This is the C program fragment available to you. What would be the output of this particular program? Is it A 1111? Is it B 0100? Is it C 1001? Or is it D 1101? I would highly encourage you to please pause the video for a while and try to answer this particular question on your own. Okay, let's move on to the solution. In this particular program, as we can see, this particular integer is having a value equals 1. This particular integer is having value equals to 1 as well. Integer C, I declared another integer called C and assigned it an expression plus plus a or b plus plus. And to this particular variable, I assigned an expression b minus minus and minus minus a. Now here we need to focus on these two expressions, this one and this one. Now let's try to understand these two statements separately. As we know, value of a is 1 and value of b is 1. And value of C and D depends on these two expressions, right? Let's consider this particular expression, plus plus A or B plus plus. Plus plus A means pre-incrementing the value of A. We know this already. Here the value of A is 1. Therefore, after pre-incrementing this value, this becomes 2. Let me update this value here as well. And we know this point already, that the values of operands associated with these logical operators would be either true or false, right? These are the two operands associated with this particular operator called OR operator. Whatever the value they hold, it would finally be either true or false. Value other than 0 is always treated as true, therefore, this particular value 2 is treated as true. B++ will post increment the value 1, right? And we know this already, that post increment simply means that after the completion of expression, increment the value. But this expression is not yet completed, therefore the value taken from this particular variable would be 1. This is also a true value. True or true is equal to true, right? Therefore, value stored inside C would be equal to 1. As C is an integer variable, therefore it will store an integer value. Now, after completion of this expression, post increment will happen. That means this value now becomes 2. After understanding this whole expression, let's move to this particular expression. Here we are decrementing the value of B, but we are post decrementing the value. Therefore, value it will take will be 2. This means true. And minus minus A means it will first decrement the value of A, and then this value will be used in the expression. 1 means true. And true and true is equal to true, right? Final result of D would be equal to 1. But as we know, this is post decrement. Therefore, after completion of this expression, this value get updated to 1. Now what would this printf function will print? It will print 1, 1, 1 and 1. Therefore, the final output of this particular program would be A. Right? No, this is wrong. This is not the right answer. But why? Why is it not a right answer? What is the reason this particular option is incorrect? Let's try to understand our solution once again. This solution is a wrong solution. Totally wrong. Now let's try to understand where we are going wrong. As we know, after pre-incrementing the value of A, this will become 2 and this means true. Okay, at this point in time, everything is correct. But if you remember the concept of short circuit that we already learned in the lecture when we talked about the concept of logical operators, short circuit in case of OR operator simply means that whenever you encounter true, rest of the statements after that will not get evaluated. B++ because of short circuit will never get evaluated, because we know that true or with anything is always true. It doesn't matter whether this will be false or this will be true. Therefore, implementing this particular expression does not make any sense. Therefore, it will never get implemented, and hence the final output would be true. Definitely the value contained inside C would be 1, but B will never get incremented after the completion of this expression. Now this is the post decrement. This simply means it takes the value 1. 1 means true. Pre-decrementing the value of A will make this value 1, and after that we will use this value in this expression. This also means true. True and true is equal to true. Therefore, D will store value equals to 1, right? But wait, after the completion of this expression, this will get evaluated. This simply means that 1 will get updated to 0. Therefore, the final output would be 1101. Instead of 1111. Hence, D is the correct option.